Hello everyone and welcome to the first episode of our YouTube series, Learning to Fly with Microsoft Flight Simulator. I'm your host, Flight Streamer. I stream Flight Simulator flights and I'm a private pilot in real life. I've flown a Cessna 172 like this and actively fly Diamond DA40, videos of which I'm sure you've seen already. So in this series, we'll explore advanced procedures for Flight Simulator users. Please note that this content is not intended for real-world flight training in any way. Always refer to your airplane POH and your local regulations. Today, we'll be using WBSIM mod of Cessna 172 in Microsoft Flight Simulator. We'll be flying out of Kitchener-Waterloo Airport in Canada. I've included all details in the description, but if you have any additional questions, please do ask in the comments. In this first episode, we'll cover engine start, run-up, taxiing, and takeoff. So grab your flight controls and let's get started. Also, a quick reminder to hit that like button if you enjoyed this tutorial. And if you're new to the channel, I'd appreciate if you hit subscribe so that you don't miss the next episode. So here we are inside the cockpit of Cessna 172. Since this is an advanced tutorial, I hope that you have a basic understanding of cockpit layout and key instruments. If not, you can still follow along without much problems. Before we start the engine, let's run through our pre-engine start checklist. We assume that pre-flight inspection, walkaround, and passenger briefing is complete. If you'd like, I can go through a typical walkaround or passenger briefing in the next episodes, so please do let me know in the comments if you'd like me to go through it. So let's go through our pre-engine start checklist. Seatbelts are adjusted. Fuel shutoff valve is on. Fuel selector valve on both. Circuit breakers are all checked and all in. Avionics switch is off. Brakes are tested and set. Now that our checklist is complete, let's start the engine. To start the engine, let's follow these steps. Mixture is idle, which is the red knob. Throttle is open to 1/4 to 1/2 inch. Beacon is on. Master switch, battery only, is on. Now let's turn on the auxiliary fuel pump and listen for the sound. Advanced mixture rich until fuel pressure rises. And once positive pressure, advanced mixture to idle and cut off. After that, let's turn the fuel pump off. Make sure that propeller area is clear. Now we're ready for engine start. Let's engage ignition by turning magnetos to start.
Clear!
When engine starts, we advance mixture to full rich position. Please note not to crank the engine more than 10 seconds to prevent damage to starter. And then we adjust throttle to 1000 RPM. Now let's check oil pressure. Make sure it's in the green range. Then we lean mixture for taxi. Now it's time to turn the alternator on and we check the ammeter is charging the battery. Now we've done a workaround, let's retract the flaps. Navigation lights on. Avionics switch is on. And now let's turn on our GNS units and transponder and set transponder to standby. We'll also check the heading indicator, set it according to compass. And at last, we'll set the altimeter based on aerodrome elevation. Before we start moving, let's quickly check the brakes. Let's release parking brakes, roll and check if brakes are operational. Now with engine running, let's move on to the run-up. During the run-up, we'll perform a series of checks to ensure aircraft is ready for takeoff. Let's maneuver to run-up area and face the wind. We'll use apron 3 alpha. Now let's go ahead and start the run-up procedure. First, we want to make sure that nose wheel is straight. Brakes are set and we're gonna hold the brakes. First, let's check flight controls. Make sure that they're free and correct. We'll check the elevators, up, down, and then ailerons, left, and right. Make sure that the fuel shutoff valve is on. Mixture is full rich. And now let's advance throttle to 1800 RPM. Let's check magnetos. We're looking for a max drop of 125 with maximum difference of 50. Engine gauges in ammeter is checked. Vacuum is in the green arc. Annunciator panel checked. And now let's set throttle to idle and let's do the idle check. Once idle check is complete, let's set the throttle to 1000 RPM. Flight instruments set. Fuel quantity is checked. And trim is set for takeoff. Now that the run-up is complete, we're now ready to taxi to the runway. Before taxiing, let's check our surroundings for the obstacles or other aircraft. In this flight, we'll taxi to runway 14 via Alpha Charlie across runway 08. We'll use our rudder pedals and brakes for tight turns. As you apply brakes, make sure you don't apply power so that you don't wear the brake pads. We've arrived at the runway 14 and now holding short. It is time for takeoff. Let's go through our pre-takeoff checklist. Trim set for takeoff, flaps 10, landing lights on, cabin doors and windows are closed, seats are adjusted. We'll also assume that departure briefing is complete. Transponder set to altitude, brakes released, and approach path is clear from traffic. As we smoothly apply full throttle, make sure to maintain centerline using rudder pedals. As we reach a speed of 55 knots, gently pull back on the yoke. Congratulations, we're airborne. Once we reached safe altitude, we can now start our climb and retract the flaps. As we're climbing, we want to maintain our best rate of climb speed of approximately 74 knots. There you have it. That wraps up our first episode of Learning to Fly with Microsoft Flight Simulator. Today we successfully went through engine start, run-up, taxiing and takeoff procedures in Cessna 172. As you continue to practice these techniques, you'll become more comfortable and proficient in your virtual flying skills, including our upcoming series for VATSIM. Be sure to join us for our next episode, where we'll cover additional advanced procedures to help you enhance your flight simulator experience. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to our channel for more exciting content. Thank you for flying with us, and we'll see you in the virtual skies.